This week's Ask Dr. Durie comes from a patient with MGUS, monoclonal gammopathy of undetermined significance. And the question is, do I need to have a bone marrow test? And this is obviously a very, very good question because when you have this low level of disease, it's important to know, is it at a level where maybe it's progressing into smoldering myeloma or maybe even early active myeloma? And so if a bone marrow is needed to get that answer, then it needs to be done. We have a new study from Iceland, part of the IMF-supported iStop-MM project, which helps to give advice in this setting. And so what the iStop team did is they looked at simple blood testing to see if that would give an indication if the bone marrow percentage would be above 10%, which would mean that the patient actually has smoldering myeloma or is moving towards active myeloma. And so they just took some simple blood tests, looking at the type of the myeloma, the level of the free light test, the level of the myeloma protein level, and also the level of the normal immunoglobulins, IgG, IgA, and IgM. So using these simple blood tests, they were able to predict very accurately that if a bone marrow test was performed, their percentage would be less than 10%, and so they would fall solidly into that MGUS category. And so this means that just using these simple blood tests, a bone marrow testing can be avoided, which is great for the patient, it's great in reducing the costs, and just generally good for the whole healthcare system. And so we're very pleased that this study has just been completed and the results are being published April 1st, 2024 in the journal Annals of Internal Medicine. And so I think that this is an important step forward. And so bottom line, here in 2024, there is now a possibility to safely avoid that dreaded bone marrow test and continue to monitor with regular testing.